Tonight, we'll hear stories of people surviving that tragedy and how the community eventually came together to rebuild. We start with 41 Action News anchor Taylor Hemness.
Matthew Stevens showed me the street where his house used to sit. The tornado ripped through this neighborhood. When it did, it also took one of Matt's legs. That is the most obvious in a long list of hurt.
On my bone in my left arm, I've titanium plates and there's still a compound fracture of my tibia, femur, and sent my kneecap flying. I also endured two spinal fractures, skull fracture, severe whiplash that's caused a bulging disc in my neck and a broken pinky.
A decade later, Matt's body still gives him other tiny reminders of that awful day.
It was about 2 months ago I pulled a piece of wood out of my head again. X-Acto blades and disinfectants, all of that. Pulling, you know, inch pieces of wood out of myself, or glass, gravel, and it still continues to this day.
41 Action News interviewed Matt in the hospital just 2 days after his leg was amputated.
I wouldn't really mind waking up with no legs and no arms. I would still live my life, try and live it happily.
Matt's goal is still the same, but 10 years in, it's not much easier.
This has made me slow down my life tenfold, both physically and mentally. The surgeons that operated on me said that I will be experiencing pain for the rest of my life due to the injuries, and they were not wrong.
In the last few years, Matt has struggled to get consistent access to pain medication. He says some days his injuries hurt so badly that he's unable to get out of bed. Sadly, his mind is in just as much pain.
A storm rolls through and I shut down. All I can do is shake and cry.
We spoke to Matthew here in one of Joplin's parks where the memorial to the tornado victims is located, but he told me he actually doesn't come here very often, choosing instead to go out into nature and quietly reflect on the events of 10 years ago. In Joplin, Taylor Hemness, 41 Action News.